I still get questions about DACs. Which input gives the best audio quality, etc.? If you have these questions or want to know more about how a DAC works, this might be the video that leads you to more videos. This year my wife and I have planned to tour Europe with our little pop-top camper whenever we feel like it, like now. But instead of forgetting you, I'd like to point you to videos I made earlier that you might find interesting. When I made this video, I had 571 videos to choose from, so there was plenty to choose from. In this video, I'll point you to videos that explain more about DACs. Links to the mentioned videos can be found in the top right corner of the screen, at the end of this video, and in the description. This video is 9 years old, but still relevant. Ignore the reference to the Hans Beekhuizen project, as that site is closed down a few years ago. The video is about input interfaces you can find on DACs. What interface exists and what properties do they have? There are also some comments about the quality. The second part of connecting your DAC explains why digital connections can affect the sound quality. It is mainly based on SPDIF that uses bright graphics and is appreciated by many. It has been viewed more than 50,000 times. In this video, I discuss the power supply of a DAC and its influence on the sound quality. I also describe the types of inputs on a DAC. What is the difference between isochronous and asynchronous? What are the inputs and why is that important? This leads to the question, which clock is the master? The one on the sending device or on the DAC? Once a signal enters the DAC, it needs to be converted to analog. In most cases, the signal is upsampled and then converted, although there are also DACs that do not oversample. And when the signal is converted to analog, still things can disturb the sound quality. DACs are precision instruments, at least the better ones are. The difference between DACs are easily to hear if you have a good stereo system. A €500 stereo in a box system may have other issues that mask the distortion caused by jitter. But the sound quality of a well-chosen stereo, if carefully set up, will certainly improve with the addition of an audio quality network switch or filter. And that brings us to the end of this video. There will be a new video coming soon. So subscribe to this channel or follow me on Patreon, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram or TikTok to stay up to date on new videos. Patreon and YouTube Premium subscribers see my videos a week early and free of commercials. Help me reach even more people by giving this video a thumbs up or link to this video on the social media. I would greatly appreciate it. A big thank you to the viewers who support this channel financially. It keeps me independent and is a nice token of appreciation for my work. €1, £1 or dollar or equivalent is already very valuable in a time when declining advertising revenues and a declining dollar are putting pressure on my motivation. You can find the links in the description below this video on YouTube. I'm Hans Beekhuizen, thank you for watching and see you in the next video. And whatever you do, enjoy the music.